What do Iron Man, dead dinosaurs, and soft tissue all have in common? Well, not a lot apparently, but it's kind of how one young Earth creationist explains how dead dinosaurs support the claims that the Earth is only a few thousand years old. Hang on to your hats, this is going to be a bumpy one. Hello, I'm the Skeptic. I watch videos on YouTube that make extraordinary claims, whether that's flat earth or strange conspiracies, but mostly the claim that a god is real, and then explain why I can't accept their position. Before we get into today's video, please do subscribe, hit that bell notification to be alerted for my next video, and drop a like. That would be amazing. In this Internetia video, Matt Powell, a young Earth creationist YouTuber with over 10,000 subscribers, tries to explain that dinosaur soft tissue discoveries support the claims that the Earth is only a few thousand years old. So let's see where this one goes.
Hey guys, this is Matt Powell. So evolutionists love to use dinosaurs to try to disprove the Bible and disprove young Earth creationism. And they will use God's own creation against him.
I'm intrigued to see where this is going, as usually you can't disprove something that hasn't been proved, but I guess we should persevere.
One of the things that I think is important to share with people and with your children and with your loved ones that believe in evolution is the fact that we actually find soft tissue from dinosaur bones. We find collagen, we find blood cells with hemoglobin still in the blood. We also find DNA, dinosaur DNA. And so these are all things that should have deteriorated if they died out 65 plus million years ago.
And it's extremely rare that soft tissue survives, but apparently not impossible. According to some scientists, preserved under very unique circumstances, the iron-rich blood from dinosaurs combined with perfect conditions could preserve tiny fragments of soft tissue for hundreds of millions of years. Though it has also been reported that sometimes what appeared to be soft tissue were actually a coincidental fossilization process. For instance, red blood cells supposedly found in a T-Rex skeleton could have been the chemically transformed and fossilized remnants of dino blood. As for DNA found on dinosaurs, some suggest it could have been human or living fungal contamination. Without knowing anything for certain, why do you get to assume anything?
And so we're finding soft tissue and DNA inside of duck-billed dinosaurs. We're finding it inside of T-Rexes with Mary Schweitzer's discovery in 2005 and in 1990.
And these findings have the tiniest of tiny fragments.
These discoveries literally prove beyond any shadow of doubt that these creatures died recently.
Oh, facepalm.
And not millions of years ago, because organic material can only last a maximum of about 10,000 years before it will deteriorate.
Though the articles that all this comes from still states that these samples are in fact millions of years old. Are you trying to twist this to fit your narrative, Matt?
Now, evolutionists will go running to preservation. They think that preservation techniques are the reason that the dinosaur DNA or blood with hemoglobin in the cells didn't deteriorate for millions and millions of years.
And if it could be demonstrated that this was the case, what's wrong with that? But if science went, we got this wrong, but now we have a better understanding, which happens all the time, we could probably accept that too.
And they think that somehow there was preservation that took place. But if I was to take dinosaur soft tissue or DNA and put that DNA inside of an airtight jar, and take that airtight jar and put that in another airtight jar, and then take that airtight jar and put that in another airtight jar, and in another airtight jar and another airtight jar, look, deep time will always cause things to deteriorate.
How do you know in those circumstances it absolutely would? Has dinosaur soft tissue been preserved in airtight jars for millions of years? I don't think so.
You can't run to preservation and say that somehow it was magically preserved over the course of millions of years. That's just completely irrational and illogical in every sense of the word.
And you can't just say a being poofed creatures into existence with magic without demonstrating it. And also, irrational and illogical are two words, just FYI.
And number two, when Mary Schweitzer had to deal with this, because remember, when she made the discoveries in 1990 and in 2005, evolutionists were criticizing her and saying that she needed to come up with a mechanism for how these things lasted for 65 plus million years. So Dr. Schweitzer's conclusion was that if you put dinosaur blood or blood of any creature and encapsulate it in iron, that the iron will preserve the blood cells, and that's how it lasted in deep time. This is their claim.
Why are you calling scientists evolutionists? I'm sure these evolutionists have far more qualifications than either of us. And because this is all relatively new in terms of scientific discovery, I'll wait until there's more data before taking a position, instead of going, I don't think this is true, so it must mean that dinosaurs died out a few thousand years ago. No, Matt, no.
But the truth is, when we look in nature, we don't see things magically getting encapsulated by iron when they die.
Or being encapsulated in multiple airless glass jars either.
Nature doesn't do that. I mean, if you slay an animal and you put it out in nature, you even cover it with sediment, nature doesn't automatically just encapsulate dead organisms inside of iron. It does the exact opposite. It scatters the DNA molecules. Since when does anything in nature die and get encapsulated by iron by nature?
And these are great questions, which is great to see. How does that happen? What chemical reactions make tiny fragments of soft tissue get preserved? What did the skeptic have for lunch today?
It just doesn't happen. So their claim that, well, iron could preserve it, okay, maybe. To claim that nature somehow does this is completely pathetic, because we don't ever see that in nature. We don't see organisms getting encapsulated by iron. It just doesn't happen. So their rescue device, that iron could be what's preserving the blood cells, just falls apart at the fundamental of what we observe nature do to organisms that die. Nature doesn't magically encapsulate organisms in iron and magically preserve things. Everything that dies in nature deteriorates over time.
No one actually says that dinosaur fossils got swallowed up by great swathes of iron, like Jarvis covering a dinosaur in an Iron Man suit.
And so this is just great proof that dinosaur DNA, dinosaur blood that we're finding in all sorts of different dinosaurs, whether it be a T-Rex or duckbills, baby duckbills, these things all prove that dinosaurs died recently. Even a child can learn to defend the Bible using God's creation, using his beasts, the dinosaurs.
A child could say Santa exists. It doesn't make it true.
And can learn to defeat evolution. This is information that we need to always remember. And their weak rescue device of, well, the blood could be preserved by iron. Since when do we see that in nature?
When scientists dig up bones and go, I wonder what this could be. It looks like blood, but it may not be. We'll have to test it, I guess. Oh, hang on, there's an explanation for it. Let's hope no theist cherry-picked the part where we got excited about finding soft tissue, but don't accept the method for which it was preserved and then use it to claim that it supports young Earth creationism. Oh, hang on. Hello? Matt who?
And it doesn't make sense. Because it's not true.
I suddenly forgot what he was talking about. How did he do? Are you convinced suddenly that the Earth is only a few thousand years old? How would you have responded to Matt? Let me know in the section below. But for now, let's skeptic this argument off the list as one we never have to listen to again. And speaking of socials, which we absolutely weren't, I have a TikTok with similar themed videos, albeit slightly shorter, but more frequent. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe if you haven't already. From me, the skeptic, stay safe, keep thinking logically, and ask questions. Skepticism is the first step towards truth. See you next Saturday.